Hey guys, thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you're watching, I assume that your baby is probably congested or maybe teething. Well, you're at the right spot because today we're going to be learning a little bit about how to ease those discomforts with infant massage. Infant massage is so important for our babies. Not only is it important for teething or congestion, but in reality, infant massage in general is really helpful for your baby's brain development. It'll help release positive hormones, and if you see statistically with research, you can show that a baby's brain will be completely different when they're touched and loved. So infant massage is definitely a great skill to learn to help soothe your baby and to help your baby's brain development as well. All right, so when you're starting your infant massage, you want to make sure that you're attuned with your baby. So basically what that means is that you and your baby both have, you know, eye contact, and you can kind of sense that she's being, he or she are open and willing to be massaged. She's not hungry, she's not fussy, she's not sleepy. I was trying to do this infant massage earlier and she was just not having it. She was hungry. So we took a little hunger break, and then throughout it, you kind of look at her cues. Yes, we want to help her if she's congested, and yes, we want to help her with her teething discomfort, but if your baby is fussing and uncomfortable, and they will let you know, right? Some cues are coughing, some cues are arching a back, some cues are looking sideways. All of those things are warning signs for you to say, hey, you know what? I don't think you like this. Let's move on to a different one. So another thing you want to do is you want to breathe. What happens is that if we're overly anxious or overly stressed or feeling tension, we're transferring that to our baby. So you want to make sure that you're wiggling that out and you're kind of breathing and, you know, de-stressing, so that when you do touch your baby, you're not transferring all of that negative energy. So another thing you want to do is you want to communicate. So always, touch is important, right? But it's also important when your baby acknowledges and wants to be touched. There's moments where they don't want to be touched, like when I mentioned those cues. If they are giving you those fussy cues, then you stop it, right? So we're starting to teach your baby positive and negative touch, and that starts from an early age. Now that you've covered those three steps, right? So you've attuned, you've taken a breath, and you've communicated with your baby, you can start with the massage. So one of the first things you wanna do is you wanna kind of cusp your baby's cheek around. So you kind of make a heart shape over her face. And again, your baby is unique. So if baby likes it a little bit tight, if your baby doesn't really like it that tight, maybe they like it up over their head, not so much on their eyebrows. But what you wanna do is you wanna sweep over their faces, moving the blood flow throughout her face. Really helpful. Just go ahead and do like a heart shape and just go around the face and frame the face. And so you want to do this a couple of times, again reading your baby's cues. My baby likes it better when I do it over her hair rather than so much on the forehead, but we do want to get touching the forehead, especially if your baby is congested. So in the image you'll see congestion accumulates, right? So it's all of the fluid that your baby has stuck within the frame of the face. So a lot of it is stuck here next to their cheeks and above their eyebrow. So you wanna make sure when you're massaging for congestion that you are hitting these spots. My baby didn't really want those spots to be hit. She's not congested, so we kinda let it be. But if you're really trying to help your baby with congestion, fight the motion a little bit, just for a little bit, and try to get those spots, and then let's not torture the poor baby. Let him be.
So really important when you're massaging the nose, you want to move up, down, proceeding all the way down the nose. Their noses are so small, so it really is a quick trip. But once you're down, go ahead and massage the area around her cheek as well.
So another thing you want to do is you want to get your little fingers and you're going to do circular motion and all around their little frame of their face. So again, when we're doing circular motion, we're not pressing so deeply where we're hurting, and especially, you know, the temple. Oh my goodness, I used to wrestle with my dad when I was growing up, and he'd call it la llave, right? And so he'd like jam his little thing. Okay, we were not abused, but it was part of the wrestling game. So do not do that to your baby. They cannot tell you, hey, it hurts. You always gently rub. You're not doing a llave like my dad used to do. I'm fine. I grew up fine. For the teething, we hold a lot of tension around our mouth and our jawline. So you want to make sure you're doing that around their jawline.
So here's a crazy fact. Turns out that babies already have all of their teeth inside of their skull. So you wonder why they're so uncomfortable. You think?
Another really good thing is you kind of pull on their little jaw and massage their jaw around their little like, what would this be? The butt chin that Elvis Presley had, the little, this area here, you want to make sure you massage and you rub around, because again, that carries a lot of tension. And above the lip as well, you can kind of do like a fake mustache on your baby and just rub around, okay? And then another thing, I mentioned that it's connected, right? The ears, this is not your ears, the ears, the nose, and the mouth, right? So you wanna make sure that you also tackle the back of the ears, you know, because all that carries tension too. And who doesn't like a little earlobe massage? They love it. Look at Jimena's face, isn't she so adorable? She loved it. She loved the ear massage better than anything. When you end the massage, you always want to end it with a gentle touch, kind of firm gentle touch, letting your baby know that the massage is over. Go ahead and please comment down below what you would like to see next. If there's anything in particular that you still have questions about, I'm here. I can help answer some of those. And please subscribe to see more videos similar to this. I have lots of content. We have educational ones like these, or travel, because we all like to travel. And yeah, just videos that are fun. So thank you for watching and like my video. Bye, see you next time. Before you get started with your massage, you want to make sure, I almost fell, but you want to do a couple, so I literally was like this, because this thing moves.